fellow astrologer, I read a lecturer in metallurgy. I'm a scientist, a new skin, capable of holding the new wine. People who are drunk with the old wine of the dead natives, as in the university professors are, they desire not the new, and they are incapable of intuition, of thinking themselves. They only know what this man said, that man said, this professor said, that professor said. They are spiritually blind. Spiritually alive people are illiterate people who ponder over their heart and not looking at which book or which other this man said or that man said, what their heart said. The God is in over here in the heart. So they will take the thing which are pleasing to God, and God will teach them how to speak. So this is a parable of the Matthew 13, verse 24 to going on further, you know, where Jesus explaining the wheat and tares. So this is the end of the age now. That's why the tares are bundled up in Israel for final burning after 2,000 years. And they are the demonstration nation of the world, and we should appreciate their sacrifices. And here it goes. Holy Gospel of our Supernatural Father Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, the same thing. They are the living supernatural, not the dead one. Delivered by the First Anointed Christ, which in my native language, Punjabi, we call Satguru Jesus, or the highest living God, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, that dwells within his most beautiful temple. This is most beautiful living temple, not dead one, not dead of the brick and mortar. Living temple of God, created by the greatest artist, demiurge, potter. Demiurge Potter, the Lord of the Nature, whatever you see with two naked eyes, belongs to, created by Yahweh. The soul inside, to make it living, is of Elohim. Lord of the Nature, Yahweh, Brahma, Khudah, same thing. And it is called Harmandir. Har means God, Mandir means temple, temple of God. Our Emmanuel, God is with us. If your heart is not greedy, if you are a greedy person like Judas Iscariot, God cannot live in that temple. So that's why Judas Iscariot was thrown out of the 12 by Christ Jesus. He was not worthy to enter the temple or enter the courtyard of our supernatural Father, or enter the bridal chamber. According to Saint Matthew 13, verse 36-43, Jesus dismissed the crowds and went into the house. His twice-born brethren, Talmidim, students, Sikh, that they call them Sikh of Nanak, and not the once-born disciples of the Rabbis. This is a corruption by the Messianic Jews. The crook temple priest, the husbandmen of the winepress that formed the corrupt moral laws to increase their income, money, and the prophet used to come and rebuke them, and they beat them, they killed others. They killed Zechariah in the temple, one of the prophets. To increase their income. So his brethren approached him and said, explain to us the parable of the wheat in the field. He said in reply, he who sows good seed to is the son of man, which is the primordial Adam Shiva. Now Jesus' Hebrew name is Yeshua. It is made of two words, Yah from Yahweh, and Shiva or Shiva means the first primordial Adam. So Jesus was second Adam, and Mary was surrogate mother, and Joseph a foster father. So that is the first proof of the virgin birth of Jesus. So Shiva, the field is the word, the good seed, the children of the kingdom of heaven, born of water, salt, people of salt, who can build their covenant with Adam, who can build their covenant with a tribal father, you know, like in Jewish people with Abraham. The Jew who are outwardly Jews and not of inwardly spiritual, they can't build their covenant with Abraham. So they are the one sons of Satan, bundled up in Israel for final burning. And that's why the western wall of the temple is intact. Because when you want to worship God, you face east. And when you worship Satan, when you want to repel Satan, you face west and throw 7 stones at him. So that's why this western wall is intact for the sons of Satan to worship. Covenant with Adam, the weeds are the children of evil one. Evil one is Al-Djmar Al-Aksa. The President Morsi was the last example of the Al-Djmar Al-Aksa, who wanted to exploit people in the name of religion, Muslim Brotherhood. And the Egyptian, they worship Adam, and keeping their character intact, they put him in jail and let him die there. So such is a typical example of the sons of Abraham, who are still faithful to Abraham. Al-Djmar Al-Aksa, the most powerful Satan, who was making Jews of appearances, making Jews of appearance by putting on shawl and all that, you know, and other people wanted to be like that, sitting in front of the temple. No problem, get yourself circumcised and you can go there. And that is how the circumcision was made cheap. And angel Stephen, the first martyr, he was angel, prophet. He went to the temple to tell them that our forefather Abraham was a noble man, and don't make fake sons of Abraham through circumcision. And that was their business. They are grinding their teeth to kill him. They took him out and killed him. Now the same people, fake sons of Abraham, that they have created themselves, are going to kill them. So beauty of this dark age is this, that you, whatever you sow, so shall you reap. So you cannot blame a third person. So they created themselves, the circumcised Aryans. They have nothing to do with Semitic race. So they created by the sake of money, and now they will have to be suffering, facing them, and they will kill them. The weeds are the children of evil one, Al-Djmar Al-Aksa, the most powerful Satan, who were making Jews of appearance. And the enemy who sold them is the devil, Satan Al-Djmar Al-Aksa, like Morsi. He was the Satan who wanted to sow the Muslim Brotherhood. They have nothing to do with politics. They are not really secular people, they are spiritual people. Muslim, Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Jew, they are spiritual men, not physical men. Not a single Jew died during the Holocaust, because Jew is one who is inwardly spiritual and not outwardly physical. The harvest is the end of the age, which is now, and I'm expecting the atomic war to take place soon after 14 November 2023. Now let's see what will happen. If things are brewing up, you know, now. End of the age, both the Palestinian and Hamas and Fatah and Jews outwardly are unfaithful to Abraham and Yahweh. They are the tear sons of the Most High Satan. The Son of Man will send his tribal angels, Son of Man, the Adam, you know, this planet Earth belongs to Adam and his sons. So he will send the tribal people to kill them. And they are in Russia, China, and others. That's why Russia will win this atomic war. The Son of Man will send his tribal angels, and they will, the tribal angels are salt of the earth. The people who are Jew outwardly, they are saltless people. They killed Jesus. Tribal angels, and they will collect out of his kingdom all who cause others to sin and all evildoers. That is, Morsi is a typical example. And these Mullah, Ayatollah Khomeini, and all those people are typical example of those evildoers. They will throw them into the fiery furnace. That means when the sectarian riots happen, people kill each other, as in India in 1947, I was 15 years old, and how people killed each other, babies and old people. They put them on spears. I have made a banner in which I have described what type of tears they are, you know. Into the fiery furnace, the sectarian riots, where they will be wailing and grinding of teeth. That is what happened when sectarian riots happen. People kill each other mercilessly. Then the righteous will shine, righteous sons of man, who can build their covenant with their tribal elders, as they are in Russia, China, and other countries, but not in the West. They have forgotten their tribal identity. Will shine like the sun in the kingdom of their tribal father. So they will shine as sun come from Yahweh, and that will shine in the kingdom of heaven. Kingdom of their tribal father. They will be the Brazilian and the African living in the jungles, faithful to their tribal fathers, or have the tribal marks. They have tribal marks on their faces. On their faces, as Abraham gave tribal mark circumcision to Isaac. He did not give it to Ishmael. So this circumcision is a special tribal mark for Isaac, that no one else can have it except the sons out of the seed. Out of the seed of Isaac. Sorry. out of the seed of Isaac. And not slaves or Gentiles, that's they were doing. They were circumcising slaves and Gentiles and making them Jew outwardly. So by circumcising them, and they were then making them the sons of Isaac, and they were not sons of Isaac, so they were fake sons of Isaac. Iran is full of the circumcised Mohammedans, the tares. So that is why Iran is number one enemy of Israel. Whoever has ears ought to hear. Now the ears are only open of the illiterate people, while the people who are the university professors are got degrees, you know. They can only listen what this professor said, what that professor said. But ordinary man who has no degree, if he says something, it's deaf ear, they can't hear. So this gospel is not for the university professors. And you can see how blind they are. This, and they have prayer saying, "Our Father in heaven, our Father is no more in heaven, alienated, he is here. That Father is Yahweh in heaven, that used to be worshipped in prayer and fasting. In Christ Jesus, our Father lives inside us, so he is no more in heaven." Those people who say in the churches, "Our Father in heaven," they are spiritually blind people. Our Father is here, no more alienated. So if the Messianic Jews, they corrupted the thing, because Messianic Jews, they are the legacy of those temple priests, the husbandmen of the winepress, which Jesus was pointing finger at the last parable he delivered in the temple. So they were good for no other job than the job of a priest. So when the temple was destroyed, when the apostle died, and then they entered the church of God by jumping over the wall like a thief and not going through the gate, proper gate, where Peter was the gatekeeper. So I can tell many things, you know, but very few customers, but they will build up when this Putin is the super Hitler, when he will start killing these blasphemers, United States and West, who said Saddam Hussein had weapon of mass destruction, but none were found there. Everybody knows now that there were no weapon of mass destruction. And they spoke blasphemy against the Holy Spirit, which is not forgivable. So they will be punished very harsh. And they are the war criminals. Tony Blair and Bush, they are war criminals. And they are going scot-free, because this country, these countries are sons of Satan. Church of England, headed by Queen, head of Mammon. They like Christ is penniless. And when her soldiers die, who bring money in, in the expansion of the empire, then they say, her priests say, hireling priest, they say, they glorified God. Salvation are the people which are not the hireling of queen. They say, their soldier died for king and country, which is the gospel truth, but they hate them. So, have common sense. Common sense is Holy Spirit. If you don't have common sense, then you can't have the gospel, but the dead letters, and end up super donkeys carrying holy books, as the university professors are. Our Father God blesses everyone in agape, unconditional divine love. without agape, we are nothing. So arrows, Moses created arrows in the wilderness, and no more fighting among the brethren. That was the snake was lifted up. And in agape, which is greater than arrows, is the father of the arrows, lord of the arrows. Then if agape is exercised, then it will bring international peace. But who can preach gospel to the people? These people who are at the universities and colleges, they are dead in letters. And their blind guides, super blind guides, when leading the blind, they fall into the pits of not Holocaust, which under the Hitler took place, and Hitler killed the sinner Jews, and Putin is going to kill the blasphemers who have blasphemed against the Holy Spirit, as Peter killed Ananias and Sapphira for blasphemy. That's all out of the same, where they kept money back. So anything spoken which is not true from the heart is blasphemy. And blasphemy will be wiped out of this planet Earth. And then we have the sons of man living together peacefully. No more fighting.